Finding specific content in your Microsoft Word documents has always been fast and easy, but here in Word 2010, the search functionality built right in has been vastly improved. You can now expand your searches to graphics, tables, charts, and footnotes and more to quickly find what you need. Let's explore this using this document named Hansel Pedal Catalog. Now we're going to explore the search functionality from the Home tab. You'll notice on the far right-hand side in the Editing group, you have a Find button, the binoculars. Control F is still the keyboard shortcut, so you can use the keyboard or click this button to open up the navigation pane which appears on the left-hand side of your screen. Now there are three tabs here that we'll talk about later, but the third tab is selected where we browse the results from our current search. Inside this field is where we type in what it is we're looking for. So let's say we wanted to go to the section about roses. Well, we could type in the word rose. You don't have to press enter or click anything. The search functionality kicks right in and takes us to the page, in this case page 2, where the word rose appears. You see it highlighted in the document, but in the navigation pane we also see some information, page 2, and a little bit of context. So if we wanted to, we could view that information, make changes to it, etc. If we want to search for any of the other occurrences, we could use these buttons, but you'll notice there's only one match. So when we're done with this particular search, we can click the X, so that stops that particular search. Let's move back to the top of our document. We'll scroll up using the scroll bar and just click off to the right-hand side of our graphics. Because we want to search the document, we don't want to search inside a specific text box, for example. So by doing that, we can now go back to the search field and search for something else. But instead of text this time, we're going to look at the enhanced functionality by clicking the magnifying glass. This displays some additional options down below the Find heading. Notice we can find graphics, tables, equations, footnotes, endnotes, even comments. Let's start with tables. We'll click tables to see if there are any tables in this document. It seems there is one match. The table is found. It's highlighted or selected. And now we could work with this table. Let's stop that particular search function by clicking the X and try something different. We'll have to click outside the table and go back to the magnifying glass, and let's try equations. There shouldn't be any equations in this document, so when we select equations, notice there is one match. It's highlighted in our text box. It doesn't belong. Press delete on the keyboard to remove it. Simple editing made fast and easy thanks to the search functionality. We'll click again, just off to the right of the page, so nothing's selected. Let's try one more. Let's say you're working with others, reviewing changes that are made to the document. You may have several people tracking those changes. We'll go up to the Review tab and we'll click Track Changes. Now any changes we make will be tracked, and notice that it also changes the view of our document to the final document but showing markup as well. Now we don't see any markup on the right hand side, but we can use the search function to find any. So let's go to our magnifying glass, and this time we'll go down to Comments, and notice that we can view all the comments made by any reviewer or specific reviewers. In this case, there's one, and that's David. So when we click David, it takes us directly to that comment. So we didn't have to shift through all the different pages trying to find the comments. It took us directly to that one comment. There is only one match in this case. We could move through the various results if we had more than one using our previous and next buttons. So let's go back up to the top here in our Review tab on the ribbon and go back to Final. Now in the Final version here, we don't see any markup, so we wouldn't be able to search for comments, but we can start searching for something else. How about graphics? Click the Close button here, the X, to start a new search. Click our magnifying glass and let's go to graphics. Right away you can see that this graphic here, which is part of our table, is selected. But there are many matches. This is only 88 of 97 matches. So we can move through the various graphics using our previous button. Notice now we've got this text box selected. It's counted as a graphic. Click the up arrow again to move to another one, and so on. So we can move through them, and it's keeping track for us over here in our navigation pane. You can see it's also highlighted in the document. So it's a great way to move through the various graphics in a document without having to do it manually using the scroll bars. And when you're done, just click the Close button for the navigation pane. Closes it up. You're back to your document. Nothing's selected. And we'll move back up to the top of this document. And that's the improved search functionality built into Microsoft Word 2010.